Our sun is literally a powerhouse. After just 2 minutes of shining, it can provide the world's electricity for a year. It's truly amazing when you think about it. On a sunny day, when you wake up, you can take a hot shower, make your coffee, and watch TV, all powered by solar energy. It is amazing. Until the evening comes, and there it is, right at the peak hours of demand of electricity, sun stops shining. It's the same story with wind. Sometimes it is blowing, sometimes it isn't. But what if it was possible to efficiently store the energy from sun and wind when they are available and use them later in the evening? The good news is, it is possible. One of the most recent and promising energy storage devices are called redox flow batteries. Redox flow batteries, similar to conventional batteries, have an electrochemical cell with positive and negative terminals, and they have an electrolyte. Electrolyte is a liquid in this case that contains electroactive species such as metal. Now, the difference is that in redox flow batteries, the electrolyte is not stored in the cell itself. Instead, it is stored in two separate tanks. The electrolyte is continuously pumped into the cell where it is getting charged. The advantage of this design is that if you want to have a battery with higher capacity, which is a function of electrolyte volume, you only need to provide two bigger tanks that contains more electrolyte. You don't need to replace the cell itself, which is more expensive and way more complicated. So a cell with small tanks can power your homes, and the same cell with bigger tanks can power a remote village. Redox flow batteries are easily scalable. Surprisingly, the chemistry of this battery is not lithium. Lithium is being used in portable devices, such as your cell phones and laptops. But redox flow batteries are for large-scale applications. You don't want such a battery to catch fire or to explode, which is possible with lithium in that scale. Currently, I'm working on redox flow batteries with zinc and cerium metals. A battery with this chemistry is very safe and also less expensive than lithium. With the help of this technology, one day, which is not far away, we will be able to use the sun's power even during our darkest nights. Thank you.